In this screencast, we're going to look at the linearization of non-linear equations. Some examples that we're going to look at are the sine of y equals x times ax plus b to the minus 2. Here we want to find a and b. Why? Because if we can determine those parameters, we can put them in a form y equals mx plus b, where b is the intercept, m is the slope, and once we have those numbers, we can use the model for any xy data that we have. So the first thing to remember that our y and our x don't always have to be only a function of y or x. So we can have any combination of x and y. As long as our y is equal to some function of x, y, and or our x is equal to some function of x, and or y, we can plot this. And we'll go back to our problem. Let's say we're given all sorts of x data and all sorts of y data. And what we want to do is put this in a form that we can plot our x versus y and solve for this a and b. Let's see how we do that. So the first thing we're going to do is divide both sides by x. Why? This way we leave b by itself and not attached to either x or y. So we have here the sine of y divided by x equals ax plus b to the minus 2. Now let's take the inverse of both sides. Generally, when you see something raised to a negative power, it's easier to invert both sides first. So now we're getting something that looks closer to a linear equation, and we're going to take the square root of both sides. And now what we can do is we can plot the square root of x over sine of y versus x. Our slope is going to be our a, and our intercept is going to be our b. So how would we set this up on a spreadsheet? The first thing you would do is take all your x data and all your y data, and then you would make a column here that's just our x divided by sine of y, and now you can plot this column versus this column to get our linear equation. So let's look at another one. Here we have 1 over y equals a x minus 4 to the negative b. The first thing we're going to do is divide both sides by a. Let's get rid of this a right here. And again, because we have a negative here, I'm going to invert this. Now, whenever you see something raised to a parameter, you should be thinking natural log. So let's take the natural log of both sides. This still isn't quite what we want because of this a times y, so we use the law of natural logs such that ln of a times y is the same thing of ln of a plus ln of y, and this equals b ln of x minus 4. And hopefully you can see where we're going with this. We go that ln of y equals b ln of x minus 4 minus ln of a. So now we can plot ln of y versus ln of x minus 4. Our slope is b. Our intercept is minus ln of a. However, remember what we're looking for is that a. So we're going to have to take this a equals e to the minus ln of a, or our intercept, to get a. And finally, let's look at y equals ax plus b over x to the minus 1. Let's invert this. Note we have both parameters as a function of x, and we can only have one of them because that's what would be our slope. What do we do here? Well, we multiply everything through by x. We plot x over y versus x squared. Our slope is a, and our intercept is b.